Do you want to create festive Christmas ornaments without painting a single texture by hand? In this tutorial, we're going to use procedural shading to design fun and customizable ornaments from scratch. You will learn how to layer patterns, colors, and materials to create unique holiday decorations that can easily be tweaked and reused, making it a perfect workflow for the holiday season. Welcome or welcome back to Academic Phoenix Plus. My name is Monica and I create tutorials on a weekly basis focusing on tools like Maya, ZBrush, and Substance Painter, all aimed at building real-world skills for artists just like you. If that sounds like your sort of thing, make sure to click that subscribe button so you do not miss future tutorials. So let's go ahead and get started. All right, here is our ornament. Very exciting stuff. And by the way, you can download this for free at academicphoenixplus.com. Just go to downloads, download this file, and follow along. Let's go ahead and render to see what it looks like. And so far, so good. Let's take a snapshot of that just so we can compare. When we get started on this, the easy part is going to be this area here, which is basically chrome. So we're going to right click, assign a new material, and we're going to choose our Maya OpenPBR. And over here to the top right of our OpenPBR, we have a preset with a little asterisk. That means that there's some presets available. So let's go to presets. You can see we have a variety. And I'm gonna choose chrome. You're welcome to use gold if you choose, or jade. I mean, there's a bunch, but I'm actually gonna choose copper and replace. Now it does have a little bit of roughness, so I might reduce it just a little bit, but let's go ahead and take a look at what it looks like. Fancy smancy. Next, we want to assign a shader for this one. Now, because we're going to be doing procedural shadings, I'm going to be working a lot in the hypershade. So before I start assigning shaders to this one, let's go ahead and jump into the hypershade, our canvas of creating shaders. And the first one we're going to create is just a regular PBR surface shader. I'm going to hit tab and start typing open, and you can see that there it is. I'm going to select it and press enter, and now it's tiny. Press F to focus, and there it is. This is going to be our white shader. I'm going to kind of scoot this a little bit so I can see my attributes. You probably have it listed here, but mine is gone. You'll notice that the base color is actually not 100% white, so I'm going to go ahead and drag that there, and then also decrease the roughness just a little bit to about 0.2. So that's my first shader, and we can see what it looks like by dragging it, or you can always right click, assign existing material. Let's see what it looks like. Okay, looks good so far. So far, so good. All right, let's make another one. We're going to hit tab again, and this time we're going to type in car, and we have an AR car paint. And lucky for us, it automatically becomes red. Now you can see that the preview isn't handling it well, but if you want to, you can go to this tab here and click on Arnold and you can see the effect. You can also zoom in if you choose to. And what I want is something a little shimmery, right? Like an ornament. So what we're gonna do is, again, I'm gonna squeak this over here, and we have a variety of things we could choose from, but the one that I really want is flakes. And I want about maybe 0.2 of them. And right off the bat, you can see that we're getting some really nice flakes. Now the issue though, is that it is very flaky, but you can also see that it's almost got a chrome underneath, and that's not really the effect I want. I want it to actually look like red on top of red. So in my flake color, I'm gonna choose a red, a little bit lighter red. And there we go, very simple. So let's see what that looks like. I'm gonna right click, assign existing material. Let's choose the car paint. Now there is a scale issue here because in the preview it worked out really well. Let's go ahead and render this and increase the scale, but just a little bit. Make the flakes color a little bit lighter. My scale is about 0.03 and my density is about 0.2. And you can see that we're getting this really nice effect. All right, so let's take a snapshot of that. Next, we want to actually mix these two together so that we get a really nice effect. And that is the key word, is mix. So let's jump into our hypershade again. I'm going to close this because it's just taking up space. I'm going to click these two by holding down shift and clicking these two, and then press this little button, which is basically showing us the connection. And another fancy trick is that if you press the number 2 on your keyboard, it kind of collapses these, so I can bring them a little closer and it organizes them. And I can grab the SG nodes and press the number 1, which also collapses them. So now I'm going to hit tab and type in mix, and we're going to get an AI mix shader. And you can see that it's got two connections for two shaders. Then we're going to go to the out color and click on of white shader and drag it into shader 1. And then we're going to grab the car paint and drag it to shader 2. And now if I render, you're going to see nothing happens, and that's because we haven't assigned it. So let's select our model. We're going to right click, assign existing material, and we're going to choose the AI mix shader. And now when we render it, we're going to get something that's 50-50. Now the AI mix shader is actually pretty powerful. You can see that there's a weight, and if I change it to 0, it goes to white, and if I change it to 1, it goes to the paint flakes. So 0 represents black, and 1 represents white, and I can use a map to control this. So that's exactly what we're going to do. We're going to grab the mix weight, we're going to click on this little connection, and I'm actually going to grab the checker. Now if I render it, it works. You can see that some of it's red and some of it's white, which is excellent, but this isn't really the look I want. That's where the fancy placement node is going to happen. So up here at the top, you can see we have a placement node, and I'm going to change this to 0, and then I'm going to change this to 8. And then when we render, we get this look, which looks like an ornament. Now, perhaps you wanted to rotate it, which you can. If I try to rotate it about 45 degrees and then I render it, you might get this little error, which looks like it's just stopped working. Let's go back to the checker. As you can see, you can either click on this little connection here, which will go to the previous connection, or just go to the tab. And you want to go to color balance and turn on alpha is luminance. And now we have this. And what's fun about this is that it is completely customizable, which means that I can go in and change the color of the carpet if I choose to. So for example, maybe I'm really into green, so I can choose something like a forest green. Don't forget to change the flake color as well, but a little lighter. And now I have this. Let me go ahead and duplicate this one and move it aside. Let's go to Hypershade. I'm going to graph the network of this one. Right click, graph network. And let's make sure that we label this. So this is going to be my green. Now, if you want to make another one of these, then what you need to do is go to edit and go to duplicate and say shading network. So unfortunately, you just can't do a control D. You have to actually do shading network, and it creates the whole thing all over again. So now I can go back to my car paint and change it back to that jolly red. It's an existing material. I'm gonna label this one red, and there we go. Zoom in. And there you go. That is how you can quickly create procedural shaders and ornaments. Now let's just do a little more pizzazz here. Let's go to our render settings. We want to go to the Arnold tab. Make sure that we have our camera AA go up a little bit, and also turn on enable adaptive sampling. And I change it to 8 so it doesn't render forever. And then I'm going to scroll down and add an imager for the lens effect, and then bring in the bloom just a little bit, not too much. And now it's going to just be filled with that holiday spirit. Nice and shiny, like the holiday spirits. And that's how you can create Christmas ornaments really quickly, all procedurally done in Maya. Thank you so much for watching. I really appreciate it. Hopefully you learned a thing or two. If you did, please like and subscribe. That's your message to me, letting me know that you like this content and that you want to see more. Don't forget to go to academicphoenixplus.com and download this ornament for free, and then you can follow along. Please share my videos with any 3D artists out there that would like to learn how to create more procedural shading or any other type of Maya skills. Again, thank you so much for watching. I really appreciate it. Keep creating, and I will see you next time in the next video tutorial. Happy holidays!